Hi, my name is Ed Eckel and I am the Engineering Librarian at the Western Michigan University Libraries. This video will show you how to use the Engineering Village online database to search for articles from scholarly engineering journals, trade magazines, and conferences. Engineering Village covers all engineering and applied sciences disciplines and is a great place to start your literature search. You can access this database from either the Engineering Subject Guide or the IEE1020 Class Guide, which are available at these web addresses. You can also access it. So here's what it looks like on the IEE1020 Class page. Here is the Engineering Village link right down here in the middle of the page. You can also access it from the University Library's homepage by going to the Databases and Guides button. Go to the letter E in the Databases A to Z list, E for Engineering Village. Scroll down until you see the link to Engineering Village, and then click that link. If you access this database from off campus, you will be prompted for your BronconeT ID and password. This is what the main page of Engineering Village looks like. Your search terms or keywords will go into the search box here on the main page. You may add additional search fields by clicking the Add Search Field link. You can select where you want Engineering Village to search for your terms using the drop-downs next to each of these search fields. You can search for a specific article by title. You could also search for articles by a particular author. What I would recommend doing is setting each of these search boxes to subject, title, and abstract, because those are the fields that are most relevant for your topics. Now let's do a search. Type some keywords relating to your topic, preferably a separate set, into each of these boxes. So for example, note that terms that are similar or are synonyms, such as the terms I've typed here, aviation or aircraft or airplanes, should go in the same box with the word or between them. In the second box, you can type additional keywords. Note also that phrases like bird strikes in this example should be placed in quotation marks. You can limit your search to articles published during a particular time period using the date option just under the search boxes. Once you've added your search terms and any date limits, go to the right-hand side and click on the magnifying glass, which will turn orange when your mouse touches it. When you do any search in Engineering Village, you will get a list of articles as your results. These articles will be journal and trade magazine articles, conference papers, and occasionally patents. The boldface headings you will see are the article titles. These will be followed by the names of the authors, then by the source, which would be the name of the journal or the name of the conference, and then the date of publication and other vital information to help you identify the article. To view more information about the article, click on the article title. This will bring up a summary or an abstract of the article, giving you an idea of what the article is about. Your keywords or search terms will be highlighted in yellow. Down below the summary, you will see subject headings. These are called main headings, controlled terms, and uncontrolled terms. Along with the abstract, these give you an idea of what the article is about. These are all clickable links, and clicking on any of these will do a new search in the database on those terms. To get back to your search results, either use the back button on your browser or click the Back to Results button in the upper left-hand corner of the page. You may edit and rerun your search from the search boxes just above your results page. You can further winnow or filter your results using the Refine Results options on the left-hand side of your results page. You can limit to particular authors. You can limit to particular subjects. You can limit to document type, books, journal articles, and so on. Once you've selected your limits or filters, click at the Limit To button at the top of the page. To see if you have access to the full text of the articles, either online or in a hard copy, click on the Find It at WMU button, which you will see underneath each article. If we have full text access to the article online, you will see the words Full Text Available appear on this page. Go down to View Online and click the links that are available to access the article. If we do not have access to the article online, try clicking Availability in the Library to see if we have a print version of the article. If neither the online nor the library options are available, click on Request It to request a copy from another library. For further information on accessing full text articles, please watch the Accessing Full Text Articles video.